Existed, therefore he had to die. Let me go ahead and just do this. Some additional information. If you look on the very top right of your screen, you'll see that there's four guards. There are 9 original Genset guards, and there are 3 civilians on the loose, just walking around. Let's see if those numbers change. That 4, yep, okay, I was gonna say, so 2 guards just got dropped off on the roof, so now there's gonna be 2 more of those guys on the map, and they're gonna be in the warehouse, which makes things a bit more tedious for you if you're still trying to be, you know, upstairs, stealthing and stuff like that. You've got more people to worry about now. So you just gotta be more careful, Jesus. Like, I'm not being right now. I'm gonna wait on this guy, apparently, because he really wants to go over there. Go over here and see if there's anything in this other crate real quick. I'm not sure if I said this already or not, but I really, really wish I had a keyboard that was more silent. This is a mechanical keyboard. It's a really good keyboard. It's a Logitech, but, it's not exactly the quietest keyboard, you know, especially for ASMR. It's kind of got a clacking to it when you hit the keys. It's a really good keyboard. It, you know, that's just one of the things that you have to deal with. Good God, look at all those guards. There's 4 of them inside of each other. I wonder why they're... Oh, the spy cam. I was gonna say, I wonder why they're actually even highlighted. So yeah, we've definitely got some company now. But I'm just about done inside, so we shouldn't have to even worry about these guys. I would like to, maybe if I could, check the cages over here and see if there's something in the cages, but unfortunately I may have waited too late on that one. Stuck inside of each other. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And they're all taking the same exact path. I've never seen that before. Thank God we're not still trying to loot stuff out there in that main area. We'd probably be getting screwed if we were. Alright, let's see where this guy goes. There's no one else up here. I'm taking a good risk, to be honest with you. Alright, what do we got? Nothing in this. Nothing. Okay. So yeah, there is not a single thing left in this warehouse. That's good. We are completionists. Well, we're not. I mean, the armor is still in the vault, but I'm not gonna grab that. I'm not really not gonna try to grab the armor. That's a pain in the butt to do by yourself. You would basically have to kill a Genset guard, hope he has a key card, and then also do all of that with him within about 5 or 6 seconds of the vault so you can get the key card and put it in the slot before the timer runs out, because you only have 10 seconds to put both the key cards in that vault. Oh crap, I didn't. Gosh darn it, I didn't throw all the bags over. dang it. Okay. Whoops. I knew something was off. Let me just sit here for a second and see what we got. Looks like a couple of cupboards. Nope, there. Yep. Okay, you coming downstairs? Nope, good. I didn't want you to. Alright, let me, whoops. Let me transfer this stuff over to the edge of that grate, whatever you want to call that. I totally forgot to do that. That's funny. No big deal. We'll take care of it. No big deal. It takes longer to run stuff on the zipline than it does to actually loot this map. It almost makes me wish that I would just get the dumpster asset. Maybe I'll start doing that. I can come in over that way and kill that guy. And then just throw stuff over there. That'd be the efficient way to go about doing things. Maybe I should ditch using the zipline, huh? That'd probably be a good idea. I might do that one day. I may try that after this or something. Oh, okay. You saw my head poking up, didn't you? has a YouTube channel and does some sort of video game thing on it. We're not breaking the mold or anything, but we do enjoy it. It's fun to just record while we play, and it's, you know, it's weird. It's kind of an incentive to play video games that we may have not played otherwise. Just thinking, well, you know, someone else might watch this with me, and it's more enjoyable to kind of narrate that stuff. Also on the channel, though, and definitely more popular than the gaming, because we don't really play new games or anything, we have Pokemon card videos, Pokemon card unboxings and stuff like that, and, you know, those aren't cheap to make, but me and Seth are pretty good about finding deals, and I can't tell you how many amazing pulls we've gotten opening Pokemon cards. That was originally Seth's thing. I had nothing to do with that. I was like, yeah, sure, just do whatever you want. I actually wasn't even that crazy about it. I just thought it was a thing he just wanted to do to try it. But I'll be honest with you, I've gotten into it. I like it. I put money into it as well. I'd like to believe that we have probably easily spent, you know, $1,000, maybe $2,000 on Pokemon cards since we've started doing these unboxings, and it's not even been 2 years, I don't think. But that being said, we have gotten some seriously good stuff out of the unboxings and the openings that we've done, almost to the point to where I'm, you know, I would wager that the cards have paid for themselves, or, you know, in value, at least 50% of what we've put in, we've gotten back. So if we'd spent $1,000, we've got $500 worth of cards. And honestly, it's probably more than that. We've got some seriously rare cards that we pulled, and those videos are neat. If you want to check them out, you should give it a shot. It's not for everybody, but then again, neither is ASMR. I mean, what kind of weirdo just plays a game or, you know, finds a comb and just makes noises and whispers into a microphone? Some of my friends that I work with, I've told them about it. I'm just like, you've got to check it out. If you can't sleep, you know, just type in ASMR on YouTube and just go for it. And it's pretty crazy. Like, some of them come back to me and they're just like, yeah, this is weird. And some of them are just like, yeah, I kind of like this thing. You know, it's cool. I think the easiest way to get across what ASMR might be and to get someone to check it out would just be like, hey, did you ever watch Bob Ross when you were, you know, a kid? If you like Bob Ross, right? Well, you like how he talks, how soft his voice is. It's like, yeah, okay, well, that's what ASMR is. It's that feeling you get when you watch Bob Ross, you know, and you get sleepy and relaxed. That's kind of my way of describing it to someone. That may not be the best way, but it's a way. Alright, so I've waxed poetic about as far as I can. I don't really have much else to say. This is the first ASMR video in a while. I think I already have a shadow raid on the channel, and I think it's the diamond, maybe. I'm not sure. But either way, we do have some ASMR on the channel, but this is the first ASMR that we've had on the channel in a long time. It's probably been a year, maybe more, maybe 2 years since those other videos went up. I can't remember if they were popular at all. To be honest with you, I personally have another YouTube channel, but it's only got like 2 or 3 videos on it. I didn't have that channel for any serious reason. I just had it for fun. And I had 2 ASMR videos on that channel of me doing Payday 2. And I think each one of those videos got like 1,500 views or something like that, or up there in that area. So, you know, obviously I hit on something, you know, that people liked, and I thought, well, why don't I give it another shot? Why don't I see what I can come up with? You know, it doesn't hurt to mix things up. And, you know, we're not exactly relying on the whole YouTube thing as a source of income or anything. Obviously, we're just doing it for fun. I've got a job that I've got a full-time job, and Seth has a full-time job, and he's got a kid. And, you know, we both got all kinds of obligations and other means of income and all that crap. But the YouTube thing is just something that we're doing for fun.
See you in the next one.